Apologies if this shirt is like a magic eye puzzle and you're all having seizures right now, but I didn't really know what it was going to look like until I got in front of the camera, and now I'm too lazy to get changed. So. Hello, welcome back to my channel. My name is Sam Scott-Thorne and I am a vocal coach based in Glasgow. Now, if you'd like to meet and explore your voice a little more, you can find me on sstvocals.com. You can also find me on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter and Patreon, and I will put the handles down below. And over there. If you do decide to become a patron, you have access to early releases of reactions, vocal harmony breakdowns, lots of other cool stuff, and fast track reactions. Now, this one is another fast track reaction by my patron Matt. He has asked me to look at, and I'm going to probably pronounce this wrong, Cancion Sefaradi, and I presume Luc Arbogast. And it's from The Voice France 2013, and it's one of the blind auditions. I've not seen this, so I have no idea what I'm in for, other than it's mind-blowing according to the description from Matt, so I'm looking forward to it. Right, so this is Cancion Sefaradi, Luc Arbogast, doing The Voice France audition. Let's go. Nice medieval loot or something. Oh, wow. Okay, so we've had one person turn the chair around and kind of go, and you can kind of see why. So the guy has, his voice does not match his face. Now, I always feel kind of bad when I say things like this because your voice and your face, like, they're not kind of like standard issue, so you could sound like anything and look, you know, the opposite. But yeah, he kind of looks a bit more like a thrash metal kind of dude with the lip piercing, and I presume that's some kind of like gauge, and yeah, the skinhead and everything. Kind of, it's just a big juxtaposition between what he sounds like and what he looks like. Now, what does he sound like? So he's got a very nice kind of, I'm not going to say operatic. There's that kind of element, but it's a lot thinner. So it kind of harkens back, and it's fed into because of the kind of lute type instrument that he's playing. It just has this very kind of medieval vibe to his voice. It kind of sounds like something you'd expect him to sing in like Game of Thrones or something. It's very light, it's very bright, it's very sits kind of back here, rather than being kind of a forward place sound. A very interesting voice. So let's keep going and see what happens. What kind of reverb is going on there? Now he's dropping his larynx.
Sorry,
bit of wine. So this was really interesting to watch. So you can see everything kind of dropping in and around his larynx area. So the first part of it is very like, wherever it goes, it's all kind of very much pulled up and back placed. And then he kind of goes, and it's all now kind of gone down and forward, and it's completely changed the dynamic of his voice. Now, someone was actually asking me the other day on in the comments about how can this person be like baritone and they speak so high, and how, you know, and I get this question quite a lot, how would somebody be classed as this but they can sing this? Voice classifications to me, just like, I don't like them, because you have the capability. The human voice can do many a thing. Like, you can sing two notes at once, you can you know, like harmonize with yourself if you practice enough. You've got the capabilities to drop your larynx and change the color of your voice and deepen it somewhat, even if it's not the note but the tone. Likewise, you can get up into your head voice. Someone who could sing down here, bah, has equally got the kind of capability of going and higher. I would try, but my shoulder's still killing me. Did you see that kind of moment of panic? Like, no, actually, don't do that. So the human voice just has the capabilities to do all these things, and this guy is showing us exactly that in action. Starts off super, super high, super clean, super bright, and he's now deepened it. I like the fact that he kind of, he adds a little bit of whine onto some phrases. He's a dynamic voice user. Let's keep going. Oh, back up. Incredible. Yes! Oh my word, beautiful job. Beautiful job! You can kind of see, I love the way that they shot that audition as well, because the angle that they got really showed how he was moving his mouth around to kind of make that tone kind of swim around. It just had so much going on in such a short audition. It was very, very impressive. Also, the sound on that was very well produced as well. You know, they had a lot of the resonance was kind of captured within the mic, and it wasn't too much. Like, sometimes talent shows can go back onto post-production and they'll like really ham up the reverb and the tune and stuff, and that seemed to be you could hear slight bits where there was like a tiny echo on it, but for the most part, you were just getting to hear him do what he does best, I assume. I've not heard him do anything else, but I mean, that's a pretty big indicator of where his talent lies, I would say. So, wow, thank you, Matt. That was pretty incredible. Once again, a very good choice, so thanks. If you liked that reaction, please give it a like and a thumbs up down below. And if you want to see more from me, then hit subscribe and ring the bell. Point over there again for some reason. And anytime I release new content, you will be the first to know. So I guess all that's left for me to say is thank you so much for joining me. And how are we going to do the bye? Shall we try and go from that high place into the low place in one kind of breath? Oh, that sounds dangerous. Bye. Bye.